Do you want me to do the camera?
Ignore the camera and look
at me. Hi, my name is Elizabeth Ann Allen, and I play Amy on Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Okay.
I started out as a cheerleader. My character was introduced to the series as a cheerleader, or, well, a want-to-be cheerleader. But then later you find out that I'm not really a cheerleader, but I've been possessed by my mother, the spirit of my mother who wants to be a cheerleader. And then I go back to being, just through some reversals of spells and such, I go back to being a normal kid, not the witch, or the cheerleading witch, as it were. And then later, I sort of delved into the Wiccan. It's very confusing, my tale. My character sort of delved more into the Wiccan, and I became more of a witch, till I think by episode 3, I turned myself into a rat to escape being burned on the pyre. And then I came back in episode 5 briefly, and season 5, and then I came back again in season 6, and by then I was a seasoned witch. If that makes any sense, if you could follow that at all, the trials and tribulation. Well, I think it was the whole process of that a show can start and your character can begin in one place, and through the course of so many seasons, you evolve so far. Sitcoms, you guys have sitcoms over here, right? Sitcoms really don't, the characters never sort of evolve or change. They're the character, the same character you met at the beginning of the show is the same character you end up with. Whereas in a dramatic series, it's just, the characters change so much that the people they come in as are profoundly different in the end, and I had no idea that it would be such a profound difference. Some of the aspects I brought to the character that were mine, where I think that I've lived on my own since I was 16, so I related to the fact that she was on her own and she felt that she really didn't have people guiding her or mentors, and I appreciated the fact that I remember in high school that the people who were different or felt different were sort of chastised and left out, and that really had a great effect on me. I hated that aspect of adolescence, and I really wanted to bring that pain to Amy because she related to that. That was her life, and she was different. When I'm looking at a character, I break it down with my psychology background by looking at the history of the character. You know, I figure out how they got themselves to where they are at the present time. Like with Amy, I thought, what brought her to this moment? What has happened in the past that brought her here? And it helped me justify my choices, or the words that I was saying, it helped me make sense of them and helped me give the character direction. But ultimately, when you play the role, you kind of have to just love them for who they are and respect what's gotten them there and not judge them. I think having an educational background in psychology makes you sort of view the world differently. You realize that everybody has had some experience that turned them into the person that they are. And before you judge the person that you see in front of you, you might want to give them the benefit of the doubt that they've gone through a lot and they've experienced a lot, and that has informed them, that's created the person that they are. And I like to learn who people are before I make an immediate judgment based on my first impression. So it's helped a lot in that aspect. It's so weird. I mean, I can't believe that people think it's like a cult phenomenon. I just think of it as a fun show that I was a part of and a great family environment that I was blessed to be involved with. And I never think about it beyond then. You know, somebody asked me, how does it feel to be famous? And I said, who's famous? You know, I was like, what? And, you know, I'm just me, you know? When you come to a convention and you meet people, people are so friendly. They're so open to meeting you. And I love meeting people. I find it really exciting. I love traveling. I love the adventure of finding, experiencing new cultures. And so they share a little bit with me, and I share a little bit with them. So it's not just about, I don't feel like I'm just there as some freak show, you know? I really just feel like I'm there meeting normal people, meeting a normal person, and it's a great, fun time.